Okay, now let us continue the derivation and complete it up. In the previous video, you have seen that angle of refraction R is equal to A by 2 and angle of incidence I is equal to delta minimum plus A by 2. Now, by applying Snell's law, by using Snell's law, since it is sin I upon sin R is equal to refractive index of medium 2 with respect to medium 1. So here it becomes sin of delta minimum plus A by 2 divided by sin of A by 2 is equal to refractive index of glass with respect to air. Okay, so this is one of the formula. Now for a thin prism, you can say sin theta or thin prism, or for small angle sin theta is nearly equal to theta, so we can say that delta minimum plus A by 2 upon A by 2 is equal to refractive index of glass with respect to air. So here we can cancel out this 2 and 2. Here the sign will not be there because the sign will be neglected. So here you can say delta minimum plus A by A is equal to refractive index of glass with respect to A. Now cross multiply it up. So delta minimum plus A is equal to A into refractive index of glass with respect to A. So delta minimum is equal to A, common we can take while transferring it up there, and 1 minus refractive index of glass with respect to air minus 1. Okay, or in general you can say delta minimum is equal to A into N minus 1. Okay, so this is the complete derivation. Here you can use this formula also while doing the numerical. And if the angle is very small, then you need to use this formula. Okay, here see, I'll get it revised once again. As in the previous derivation, you have derived this, that R is equal to A by 2 and I is equal to delta minimum plus A by 2. Now by using Snell's law, that is sin I by sin R is equal to refractive index of 2 with respect to 1. So now substituting the value of I and R over here, so sin of delta minimum plus A by 2 upon sin of A by 2 is equal to refractive index of glass with respect to air. So this is one of the formula. Now if the angle of prism is very small, or you can say the angle which this sin is having inside them, it is small. So when theta is very small, so we can write sin theta as theta. So as these angles are taken considered to be small, so sin of delta minimum plus A by 2 is equal to delta minimum plus A by 2. Similarly, sin of A by 2 is equal to A by 2. So these 2 and 2 get cancelled out, then delta minimum plus A by A is equal to refractive index of glass with respect to air. Now by cross multiplying, finally we get this equation. Now we can plot a graph. This graph you have also studied in class 10th, that is the graph between angle of incidence and minimum and angle of deviation. So we plot this graph between angle of incidence and angle of deviation. So the graph comes out to be in this way. This point is taken as angle of minimum angle of deviation. Okay, so you can remember it in this way, that a tick mark of a kind of thing is there. Okay, so it is between angle of incidence and angle of deviation. Here we will mark it as angle of incidence I, and this is angle of deviation delta. So this point is delta minimum. Okay, this point is delta minimum. You can see that at some value of 42.2 degree we get this minimum angle of deviation for glass. Okay, so this is the graph between angle of deviation and angle of incidence. As we keep on increasing the angle of incidence, the angle of deviation also get changed. So at particular angle of incidence we get the minimum value of angle of deviation. Okay, I hope this derivation is clear to you. It's very important derivation from both point of view. Please do remember this diagram, mark arrows in the diagram, all the angles properly. Okay, then only you will be awarded full marks. Okay, thank you.